Wimbledon received a makeover for the Olympic tennis tournament. The big names focused on the ultimate accolade, the singles gold medal. And when the world's best players put on their country's colours, the passion was unmistakable. As well as the rackets, plenty of records were smashed. The record for the longest match was broken three times. Juan Martín Del Potro was heartbroken when he lost to Roger Federer in 4 hours, 26 minutes, and missed out on a place in the final.
It's tough to speak now. I feel sad, but Roger made a fantastic match and he's a good winner.
There were unprecedented scenes in the men's singles gold medal match, as Roger Federer, the king of centre court, was dethroned by the home favourite Andy Murray. Murray won in straight sets to win the Olympic title for Britain, their first in the men's singles in over a century. Just 24 hours after Juan Martín Del Potro was shedding tears of sadness, he was weeping with joy. The giant Argentine walked to his knees after beating Novak Djokovic to secure the bronze medal in the singles.
I feel really happy. I will be crying, but for my happiness, you know, it's tough to recover after a big loss against Russia, but I did a fantastic match, one of the best of my career, and this is for my country.
Serena Williams totally dominated the women's singles. In just over an hour, the American thrashed Maria Sharapova to claim the third gold medal of her career. No wonder the American had happy feet. And Venus was soon jumping for joy too. The Williams sisters became the most successful tennis players in Olympic history, winning a third doubles title and their fourth gold medal each. An outstanding achievement.
It's 8 gold medals at the house, so it's not bad.
It's not bad at all. And now Serena and I are even in gold. She won the singles, which I'm sure is she's always dreamed about ever since 2000 in Sydney. And if we get to another Olympics and add to that, that would be amazing.
Andy Murray had another chance of victory in the mixed doubles with Laura Robson, but it wasn't to be. Max Murney and Victoria Azarenka spoiled the party and won a first gold medal in mixed doubles for 88 years. A second medal of the games for Azarenka to add to her bronze from the women's singles. Like so many tennis players, Olympic glory has been uppermost in the minds of the Bryan brothers. Mike and Bob have now won everything there is to win in men's doubles. The Americans beating Michael Lodra and Joe Wilfried Tsonga in the gold medal match.
And about standing up on the podium and seeing the flag go up, it feels kind of surreal. You know, it just happened 20 minutes ago, and now we got this shiny thing around our neck, which is pretty unreal. I haven't really even looked at it. We could end tomorrow. We could stop playing, and we're going to be happy the rest of our lives.
The pinnacle too for Andy Murray, with scenes never before witnessed on centre court.